president is reaching out to women voters as he lends a hand to Senator Patty Murray in Washington State. Murray's locked in a tight race with Republican Dino Rossi, and like so many incumbents, she faces voters angry about the bank bailouts and the sluggish economy.
I'm sick and tired of the garbage that's going on in Washington, D.C.
When Patty Murray first ran for the Senate 18 years ago, she called herself a mom in tennis shoes. Now her Republican challenger is calling her a Washington insider.
Voting with Pelosi and Reid in the Wall Street bailout.
Stumping with Murray today, President Obama is working to make the case that his policies have helped women voters who have been hard hit by the recession. Murray holds a slight edge in the polls, and women voters could help put her over the top. From Seattle, the president heads to California and Nevada, trying to rally voters for two more Democratic senators facing tough fights. Randall Pinkston, CBS News, Washington.
A British broadcaster is under fire from the military for creating a controversial documentary about Prince Harry. The fictional film shows what might happen if the Taliban kidnap the prince while serving in Afghanistan. It's called, quote, The Taking of Prince Harry, and it's set to air tonight in London. Britain's army chief wants the program banned, saying it puts all troops at risk. But the producers are rejecting accusations that they're giving how-to tips to the Taliban. There's been no official reaction from the royals, but Prince Harry is said to be more amused than outraged.
Checking headlines around the state today, a serial scattering suspect is facing two more local charges to a seat down. Announced in New York this morning, the rise of the sheriff and deaths of Dolly Marshall Flint and Frank Kelly Reed in Flint Township both happened in July. He's already locked up on another murder charge. Prince Harry is believed
Okay, I'm missing a black.